What's going on, y'all? David Zubinski here, Colosso Strength Systems. Today, I want to talk about nutrition. Now, nutrition is a very loaded topic. There's a lot of different avenues that we can go down, and in future videos, I want to break them down in more detail. But for today, I want to give more of a general overview to kind of help you guys streamline where you should put your focus and maybe what should come later down the line. Health and nutrition, especially, comes in waves and then it comes in steps, so that's what I'm going to help lay out. First and foremost, you gotta be able to adhere to the diet. If you're eating perfectly all week and you binge on the weekend on 10,000 calories, it's not a good nutrition plan for you. Doesn't really matter what you do, that weekend is ruining everything. So again, adherence first and foremost, okay? Next up is going to be calorie control or caloric balance. Now, for a second, I want you to separate weight loss from healthy, okay? Because let's say they're 100 pounds overweight, trying to lose weight. And they're eating all whole foods, no processed foods, no artificial sweeteners, none of that stuff, right? But they're still in a caloric surplus, right? Even though they're eating all healthy foods, they're still gaining weight, which is more detrimental to your health than anything else. Obesity has been linked to all different types of diseases. It's been linked to multiple cancers. So you wanna make sure that's in check first, right? So you wanna make sure you have more calories going out than coming in, right? So again, if you're trying to lose weight, you probably should spend some time tracking your calories. Now, tracking isn't a long-term solution because no one wants to track their calories for the rest of their life, and I understand that. That being said, if you've never gone through a period of understanding what's in your food, how many calories are in the different types of foods that you're eating, that's gonna be a huge disservice because you're just guessing your way through, right? Because quality nutrition is all the food groups, right? So I would highly suggest, if you've never done that, go through a time of your life and track your food and then log into an app, something like MyFitnessPal or something of that nature, to also track your macronutrients. Macronutrients is kind of the next step. What does that mean? So your macronutrients are protein, carbs, and fats. These are what make up the majority of foods that you're eating, okay? All the foods that you're eating, okay? And you wanna make sure they're in appropriate ratios, because let's say you take 3,000 calories and it's 90% protein, or 3,000 calories that's 90% carbohydrates. Your body's gonna use them differently and it actually will affect the total caloric expenditure that we were talking about earlier, right? So you wanna make sure you have an appropriate ratio. What do those ratios look like? Again, these are general guidelines, okay? But first and foremost, you want moderate protein, let's say 30 to 40%, and that'll make sure you're in appropriate range, right? Protein helps with muscle building, your collagen, joint health, a lot of different things, right? It's kind of the structure of the body, think of it that way. Then you have your fat, it is a fuel source. Fat is a fuel source that is a little bit slower. Think jogging or your day-to-day living, right? Not high-intensity exercise. Fats are also good for hormonal health, skin health, eye health, some things of that nature, right? Then last, we have carbohydrates. Now, carbohydrates are the preferred source, fuel source for the body. So your body and high-intensity exercises or weightlifting or explosive movements like that, your body's gonna use high carbohydrates. So you wanna make sure you have those present in your diet when you're doing those types of activities. Now, let's go into some general recommendations for macronutrient ratios as far as protein, carbs, and fat. So again, we took care of the protein, let's look at the fat and carbs. Now, again, if you track your total calories, the amount of protein, the amount of carbs and fats really isn't important. You wanna make sure you control calories, control protein. Then carbs and fats aren't as important as people think. That being said, if you're not wanting to track and you're going for general recommendations and or you're looking for optimal performance, you're gonna base your carbs and your fats around your activity level. So if you're a muscle-bound individual, you're working out a lot, you're doing a lot of weight training or high-intensity exercise, you're gonna want some carbohydrates structured around your meals before, or around your workouts, before and after your meals, before and after your workouts. Now, if you're somebody who's a lot of weight to lose, maybe you grew up kind of chubby, you're still in that fat loss journey, you're gonna want probably a lower carbohydrate diet and a higher fat-based diet because you're still wanting your body to use all that stored energy that you have on your body, not the quick source of carbs that you're ingesting in quick. So instead of having carbs in the morning and your body runs off that, you're having carbs at night and your body's running off that, you have a lower carbohydrate diet, so your body starts to relearn how to use fats for fuel, okay? Next up is nutrient density. Now, nutrient density plays into your total caloric expenditure, right? Because if you're deficient in micronutrients, so nutrient density looks at as whole foods, right? These are the micronutrients that your body needs to keep all these processes going, right? So in your foods, these are your vitamins, your minerals, and your vegetables and your plants and meats and things of that nature. But for the most part, it's where you're getting your fruits and vegetables, mainly your vegetables, right? So you want to make sure you have a high amount of plants in your diet to keep your micronutrients up. If you have deficiencies, this can start to run into hormone deregulation, things of that nature that makes this entire process more difficult. Not to mention, just focusing on whole foods will more than likely, but not always, like we talked about, equate to getting your calories down just by focusing on these foods. So if you don't want to track, focus on whole foods, okay? Now, next, the last thing I really want to talk about is like kind of the psychology of eating without tracking. Now, when you eat, I want you to kind of judge your energy 20 minutes after you eat. If you feel kind of bubbly in the guts, kind of more tired, more lethargic, like you can't really focus as much, that meal didn't service you well at all. Okay. Now, if you feel a bit more energetic, a little bit more mental energy, and you're ready to take on the rest of your day, that's probably a quality meal for yourself, right? So again, judge the energy after you eat, and that'll help tell you how you did that meal, okay? Now, next, I also want you to look at foods, and this is kind of that whole foods, processed foods conversation. Now, when we look at food, people kind of take it as a cliche, whatever, but you are what you eat in the most literal sense. Your body is regenerating cells constantly. Where does that come from? The food that you eat. So if you go and eat crap food with no micronutrient value and it's been sitting on a shelf for 2 years, that's what you're becoming. And I know that sounds ridiculous, but it's the truth. And when you want high quality nutrition, you want to go get those whole nutrient dense foods because you want to get life from that food. You're literally taking food and the life that's in food, and you're giving yourself that life. So you want to make sure you are focusing on foods that are giving you a benefit rather than what can I get away with, right? A lot of times we look at, well, how many cookies can I eat? Well, how much? No. Change your mindset. Change your mindset when you look at food is, how is that benefiting me, right? What quality is that bringing my life? That's how you should look at your food. Nutrition is a major, major thing. And you really want to make sure you nail this down because it's one of the most important things. It's the only thing that you're going to do for the rest of your life other than breathe and sleep. And then water. Water is a big one, right? We're 70% water. If you're dehydrated, it can turn down fat loss mechanisms. It can turn down muscle building mechanisms. It can give you brain fatigue, brain fog, right? Stay hydrated, okay? So yeah, that's kind of a nutrition overview today. That's all I got for you today. So like, subscribe to the channel, whatever that helps me help you guys. If not, reach me at Equinox for training during the day, Garage for training in the evening, or online training at any time. I'm here for you guys. Other than that, y'all have a wonderful day.